Let's begin to talk about the general reactivity of the heteroaromatics, taking into consideration the frontier orbitals that we might expect to be involved. This will then serve as an outline for the kinds of reactivity that we're going to encounter in the next series of webcasts. So since heteroaromatics contain nitrogen, sulfur, or oxygen, and there's necessarily lone pairs there, we might be looking at reactivity that involves, as the highest occupied molecular orbitals, those non-bonding pairs of electrons on that heteroatom. And we need to be able to figure out whether or not that non-bonding pair is really very nucleophilic or very basic at all. And we'll do that in the next webcast. Since we're dealing with aromatic systems, we might find that the pi system serves as the nucleophile. This would be the kind of reactivity that we'll encounter when we talk about electrophilic aromatic substitution. The pi bond will serve as the nucleophilic source of electron, the highest occupied molecular orbital. We have a pi system, and with a pi system, there's necessarily a pi star that's empty, the lowest unoccupied molecular orbital, and so we might expect to see that the pi system can function as an electrophile, where the pi star serves as the source of an electron acceptor. All right, to begin, let's take a comparison between the 5 and the 6-membered rings of pyridine and pyrrole, and let's try to break it down in terms of what we might expect to see for the different kinds of reactivity based on the nitrogen lone pair or the pi system. So let's look at the nitrogen lone pair, and in the case of pyridine, that lone pair is nucleophilic, and so we have a very nucleophilic or basic functionality there. Actually, these rings are sometimes called the basic heteroaromatic, recognizing that that lone pair can serve as a base, and the reason that it can serve as a base is because that non-bonding pair of electrons is not involved in the aromatic pi system, and it's freely available to react as a nucleophile or as a base. What about the pi system? Well, the pi system is, as we saw, electron deficient. And so in the case of the heteroaromatics that are 6-membered ring, if we have N2 nitrogens, we can expect to find that they'll function as good electrophiles and poor nucleophiles. So that's the kind of reactivity that we can expect to encounter. That pi system is going to be likely to participate as an electrophile and not so much as a nucleophile. And drawing those resonance structures that we learned about last time will help us understand that. In the case of the pyrrole, these are known as the non-nucleophilic heteroaromatics. And so we really just want to just discount that lone pair as being uninvolved in reactivity, because the reason is because that lone pair is tied up. It's needed to participate in the 4n plus 2 pi electrons to make that ring have aromatic character. And so the nitrogen lone pair is not going to be nucleophilic or not going to be basic. What about the pi system? Well, the pi system is very electron rich, and so for that reason, it's going to be likely to be a good nucleophile and also a poor electrophile. So we can expect to see that in the case of pyrrole, it's not going to be likely to do nucleophilic aromatic substitution, where the ring serves as an electrophile, but it's more likely that we'll be doing electrophilic aromatic substitution, where the ring serves as a nucleophile.